Recently, I made a video about a number of products from BIQ that were touted as upgrades for the Bambu Lab A1 and A1 Mini 3D printers. I didn't necessarily agree that everything I looked at in that video from the Panda range was an upgrade, but that didn't stop BIQ from sending me more stuff. This week, I received another couple of items from BIQ, again aimed at those non-enclosed Bambu Lab printers, which I'm going to try out in this video. You can find links for both of these products in the description if you want to know more. So, will either the Panda Knomi or the Panda Shelter make my useful upgrade list, or are they just gimmicks? Stick around to find out. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. First up, we have the Knomi. The Knomi from BIQ has been around for a little while now for use with other printers using firmware like Clipper, but BIQ have now adapted it to work with these Bambu Lab printers. What the Knomi essentially is a round display screen with Wi-Fi capabilities. It's small enough to fit on the printer's printhead and only needs a power supply and a little bit of setup to enable it to display information about what your printer is doing at any time. Now, is this even marketed as a printer upgrade? No, not really. It's a little bit fun and has no real practical use, as all of the information it gives you is displayed on the printer's screen. As it works through Wi-Fi, you could actually take it anywhere with you around your home and see what your printer is up to if you don't want to use the app. All I'm doing today though is looking at how easy it is to set up, and I'll see if it works how it should. Now, I did actually receive the Knomi before all of the information on how to set it up was available online and before BIQ sent it to me, but I was still able to set it up. That's how easy it was. All I did was plug it in with a provided USB lead and scan the QR code that comes up on the screen with my phone, which connects your phone to the Knomi's own Wi-Fi network. You then access its setup by putting in the Knomi.local address into your phone's internet browser, and you're in. From here, you then tell the Knomi your own Wi-Fi settings, and once it's connected, it goes looking for any compatible printers on your network. When it's found them, you can select the one you want to bind it with and then enter your printer specific information, which you can find through the printer's menu. The Knomi then binds to your printer and can read the data that it is sending out over your network. The Knomi then uses GIFs or GIFs to display the information about what your printer is doing at the time. There are default files like cute faces and animations, but you can also change any of these files very easily to anything else you'd rather display. I tested this out by animating my logo in Canva and uploading it. It all worked great, and the included replacement hot end cover made it really easy to fit. The Panda Knomi gets its power from a spare AMS port, so everything you need comes in the box, except for a couple of quick printed brackets to support the power cable. Now, some of you may be thinking that with Bambu Lab's recent firmware upgrades on their X and P series printers, that they're going to block third-party access that devices like the Knomi need. This is exactly what I asked BIQ, but they said that Bambu Lab have confirmed that devices that only read data from the printer won't be restricted. As the Knomi only reads and doesn't try to control the printer in any way, it shouldn't be a problem. Now, you may have heard of PCBWay, our video sponsor, but do you actually know what they do? PCBWay offer a full PCB or printed circuit board manufacturing service, whether you're looking for a prototype or mass production. But they also offer a lot of other services that you might not know about. PCBWay also now offer 3D printing, CNC machining, metal fabricating, plus many more options to help you get that project made. Check out their website from the link in the description for an instant quote on your design and $5 off your first order. Now, back to those Panda upgrades. Next up is the Panda Shelter. This one arrived without warning, and I also have zero information other than what's actually in the box. The Shelter appears to be an enclosure for pretty much any 3D printer that fits inside it. As it's from the Panda range, then I assume it's aimed at any non-enclosed Bambu Lab printer. Either way, it was simple to assemble, well, as simple as putting up a tent, and I did it all on my own. I do think it would have been easier with another pair of hands though. Once it's set up, you can put your printer inside. There are two openings with zips, so you have a couple of options when it comes to accessing your printer. The Shelter also has a USB-powered exhaust fan with a filter and hose, which is a good idea. We're becoming more and more aware of the potential health implications of breathing in some of the particles or VOCs that are produced when printing with certain types of filament, and being able to enclose your printer and then filter and vent the air around it will massively reduce any potential risks. The other benefit is that it will be much easier to maintain the temperature around your printer when it's in an enclosure. My printers are in my garage, which I'm beginning to suspect is the worst insulated building known to man. It's basically the same temperature in here as outside if I don't heat it. So in the winter, that can be very cold. I had just finished printing an Ellis basketball when the shelter arrived, which was a print that took nearly 3 days. My main concern was the very low temperatures at night and what might happen when the air temperature dropped into the minus numbers. I ended up rigging up an improvised cardboard hood to try and maintain some stable temperatures, which did seem to work. I wish I could have used an enclosure like the shelter though. It would have made things much easier. The assembled Panda Shelter measures 850 by 600 by 600 millimeters and is big enough for the Bambu Lab A1 plus the AMS light, but not with the external spool holder on top of the frame. And there also isn't that much room for the bed wiring. Personally, I prefer to give the bed wiring on a bed slinger a bit more room than there is here, but that may be a hangover from the days when 3D printer manufacturers didn't support their bed wiring very well. Mind you, considering the issues with the A1's bed wiring a year ago, I think I'd still prefer a little more wiggle room. There's also plenty of access holes to pass wiring through and some handy pockets for any tools too. The room the enclosure takes up is also quite substantial, so you'll want to make sure you have room for it first. All in all though, it seems like the Panda Shelter could be ideal for anyone with a non-enclosed 3D printer who wants to control temperatures and filter or extract the air around their printer. So do either of these make the upgrades list? Well, the Knomi doesn't. Even BIQU acknowledged that the Knomi is just a bit of fun, but I still like it. I enjoy playing around with this sort of thing and the setup is simple enough that customizing things doesn't get frustrating. My son also likes this one, and anything that gets him interested in something other than YouTube Shorts is a win. The Panda Shelter could definitely be an upgrade though if you want to print somewhere cold, or if you just want to filter anything coming from your printer. Check out the description for links to both of these products, and if you haven't seen it, check out this video where I look at some of the other products in BIQU's Panda range. Click subscribe if you want to see that airless basketball video when I release it too. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.